Fellow Nigerians, I am not about to comment about the fight between the Nigerian Labour Congress NLC and the Nigerian Minister of Labour and Employment Chris Ngige. I am here to warn that Nigeria as a country could die very soon unless the Nigerian Labour Congress and the Nigerian Bar Association NBA act very quickly. There are urgent national issues which I have been expecting these bodies to act upon for so long, but I'm still wondering why they have remained silent. Firstly, the Nigerian Labour Congress. It is not enough that Buhari signed the 30,000 naira minimum wage into law when it was 18,000 naira. Many inept governors refused to pay. Our 30,000 naira today is just $83 in 2010, when the minimum wage was 18,000 naira, it was $122. Anytime labor agitates for increase in salary, it is very ridiculous that the government of Nigeria agrees the minimum wage based on the current price of fuel. Your 22 working days in a month multiplied by 8 hours a day means that you work 176 hours monthly. If you divide your 30,000 naira by the so-called minimum wage of today by 172 hours, it means that you receive 170 naira or half a dollar per hour. As a labor union, you mean that you will stand to watch incoming senators to be sworn in to receive 30 million naira monthly? You mean that you will stand and watch the incoming members of the House of Representatives to be sworn in to receive over 20 million naira monthly? Meanwhile, incoming federal and outgoing federal legislators have budgeted 23.7 billion naira as severance or goodbye allowance after what they had looted. They work part-time, but they supervise the work of people who work full-time. Nigeria does not need the Senate. The House of Representatives is enough. We have been saying this over and over again. They will take Nigeria nowhere. They are draining our country. NLC and NBA ought to vigorously lead this fight. These legislators are draining our economy. It is forbidden under paragraph 2 of Article 8 of the United Nations Convention Against Corruption for Public Officials to engage in self-dealing or illicitly providing him or herself emoluments that are unacceptable under international law. Nigeria is a party to that convention. State governments owe so many months of salaries and pension against Article 6 of the International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, to which Nigeria is also a signatory. You saw how desperate politicians killed us to get into office because of what they stand to selfishly profit, not because they want to serve us as a people. The National Assembly has passed 676 bills since 1999. The government has spent about 2 trillion naira on the National Assembly since then. On the average, it means that it costs Nigerians 2.9 billion naira to pass a bill, one bill. Now, who bill help? Now, who bill help for Nigeria since? Your 30,000 naira minimum wage is at least 3 workers. Is of at least 5 workers is what fuel the convoy of governors daily. That is, your 5 workers times 13,000 naira, 150k, is what some governors use to fuel their convoy every day, daily. At 30k, you can never in your entire life save what a senator earns in a month. For how long will you continue to be the bamboo that walk for monkey to chop? For how long? And you are watching? They insult our sensibilities after traumatizing us. And Nigeria will borrow to finance the 2019 budget to fund all this rubbish, and you want the country to move on? Nigerian ex-governors and their deputies receive millions of naira monthly, houses, cars for life. After looting their respective states, they become state liabilities for life. Is that what you want to allow? Are you waiting for a new set of governors to be sworn in? You will work 35 years before you receive pension, but the speaker and deputy speaker of the Kano House of Assembly, they just passed a law through which they will receive pension for life after serving for 4 or 8 years. Is that what the Nigerian Labour Congress will allow? Governor Ganduje, aka Gandola, wants to compensate them for not impeaching him when he was caught on video receiving bribe in dollars. Is compensating them for approving the division of the Kano Emirate into 5. Nigerian Labour Congress, you are the soul of Nigeria, and posterity will never forgive you if you allow this nonsense to continue. You are there working day and night, experiencing hardship, but jailed Senator Joshua Dariye is in prison, receiving 14.2 million naira, and you keep quiet. You keep quiet. You are there working day and night. Does the Nigerian Labour Congress see nothing wrong in this? Can you imagine the harm that your continued silence will do to the Nigerian child or the future generation? The Nigerian Bar Association is equally watching. Nigerian Bar Association, NBA, they protested when the former Chief Justice of Nigeria, Walter Onogen, was suspended. But they have been silent over many more important national issues. The judiciary continued to allow federal legislators to receive more than what was stipulated in law of our country under revenue mobilization, allocation, and fiscal commission. The law is there, but lawyers have refused to act. The government of Buhari continued to trample upon the rule of law. He has detained Sambo Dasuki and El Zagzaki since 2015, despite various court rulings that they should be released on bail. If somebody commits an offense, tell the person to court, then let justice be done. No man, this is not a military regime, no man has the right to detain Nigerians arbitrarily, even against the rule of law. This is the abuse of the rule of law, the peak of it. This is unacceptable. Hundreds of Zagzaki's followers, they were killed because they demanded for justice. And our lawyers see nothing wrong in this. Have you forgotten how the arrest, the incarceration, and the death of just one man cost Boko Haram to be what it is today? And we are all keeping silent. We know that these so-called bandits, terrorists, herdsmen, they have surrendered Nigeria. Nigeria is about to die unless we rise up as a people against the very few that are pushing our country into Venezuela. The Nigerian Bar Association see nothing wrong when, against the rule of law, governors pocket security votes monthly, money that they use to secure themselves and their families, while the rest of us are exposed to kidnappers and to killers. It is not in our constitution, but they collect security votes. How secure are our states today? Nowhere in Nigeria is safe, not even Buhari's Katsina state. Katsina state is on fire. And we have a president who is a retired army general. How they get to that position in the army, I don't understand. For how long shall we tolerate this nonsense? Is this Nigeria? Is this really Nigeria? Nigerian lawyers refuse to protest when, just like Buhari, Gandola installed 4 new MRs against the court order that restrained him from doing so. What is a country if it is devoid of the respect of the rule of law? No doubt about that. The action by Gandola, was the voice of Gandola, but it was the hand of Buhari. This planted display of disrespect and contempt of court is happening because majority of Nigerians have conditioned themselves to hardship and silence. They have been broken by the many years of military and civilian rule. Our people are now afraid to stand up for their rights. But they forget that freedom lives on the other side of fear. Freedom lives on the other side of fear. For how long must we be afraid to speak? Are they probably waiting for Nigerians in diaspora to come home and fight for them? During the elections, they said Nigerians in diaspora should keep quiet, that we are not on ground. Okay, now elections are over. Look at what Nigeria has turned into, because you refuse to listen to us. You decided to return recycled leaders, though that election was a coup anyway. It was a sham election. But whether Atiku or whether Buhari, these are not the set of people that we need. Look at our country today. Now that you are on ground, what have you done to change the status quo? You that are on ground, what have you done to change the status quo? It is not enough for you to say, Algerians revolted and they got their freedom. It is not enough for you to say, the Sudanese revolted and they got their freedom. When all our youths do is to watch football, Nigerian youths don't know what is happening to them, what is coming to them. If they knew, they would have heard that the Minister of Labor and Unemployment, let me use that word, has promised, so to speak, that in 2020, the unemployment rate in Nigeria will increase to 33.5%. I know that half of Nigerians are unemployed. So 33.5 in 2020 is an underestimation of the truth. Are we really stupid as a people to be this silent? Will the Nigerian Labour Congress and the Nigerian Bar Association allow this nonsense to continue? They will allow a new set of federal legislators and ministers to be sworn in to continue the vexatious pillaging of our commonwealth? I refuse to address the Attorney General of the Federation and the acting Chief Justice of Nigeria because I know that they are already in bed with politicians. I refuse to address Nigerian youth today because in January 2019, the National Association of Nigerian Students skimpily went to Aso Rock to promise Buhari nothing less than 20 million votes. Here we are. Here we are. Here we are. Even at the time that they were at home during Aso strike. Here we are. If we do not wish to continue in this mockery and hardship, if we do not want to bequeath today's sorry state of Nigeria to our children and future generations of Nigerians, if we do not want Nigeria to slide into what will even be worse than Venezuela, the time to act is now, because the time is up. Or are you waiting for two-faced Idibia to lead you in a protest march? Are you waiting for Motola Ekende to lead you in a protest march when freedom is in your hands? If you must rise against social injustice, you must do so before the end of May 2019. If you refuse to act now, fellow Nigerians, I know, just as you know, that our dear country will die very soon. And there will be no medicine after death. The signs are everywhere. By way of nepotism, ineptitude, unaccountability, and nonchalance, Buhari has completely destroyed the fabric and the fundamental balance upon which our founding fathers built a common goal. Nigeria will die very soon if the Nigerian Labour Congress and the Nigeria Bar Association do not act quickly to address these issues. There is no better time for revolution without ammunition. We refuse to preach violence, but Nigerians must say no. this hardship and social injustice is not of God. No. 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 Remember the words of John F. Kennedy. Those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable.